everybody has been supporting. All right, we get to Kano. All right, this very guy, only him again, is a powerhouse. When it comes to entertainment, forget it. This guy hold Kano down 24/7. Ladies and gentlemen, people of the world, right now, I have my first guest, my brother.
Hi, Terry.
To have you on the show.
Thank you. The way you hype me, the hyping is just something else. Hey, guys.
Oh, nice, what is the show?
It's nice being on the show.
How's everything going?
Thank God, everything is actually
fine. Thank you very much.
Fine. It's nice having me this night, Terry. And it's nice
thank,
seeing you.
Thank you very much. Yeah. It's close to a year right now.
It's almost a year.
So how is everything going with you?
Yeah, everything is finally locked down. Everybody is home doing things doing the way they're supposed to, right? You know, the lockdown will not still stop from trying to keep your life together and get the best for yourself.
Yeah.
So basically, we're managing to be at home.
Yeah.
That is for those people that don't know how to still use their time wisely to do a lot of things with a lockdown. But for people like being a journalist and event planner, I still work up and down 24/7 to survive because this is something I'm actually born to do every day.
Yeah. Right. So tonight is going to be a battle between you and I, yeah?
Yeah, I hope so. I hope it's a battle. Thank you very much.
Tonight, as you know, in Stockholm as AB.
Yeah.
All right. I wouldn't want to blow your trumpets. Mm-hmm. And your time, at least because you have some lined up.
Yeah.
So let's see how we could take 15 to 20 minutes out of the time we have. Let's get to meet you, where you're from, and all that, and what you are doing in Kano.
Oh my God, that's so nice. Well, my name is Louis Bernard. Actually, I'm a journalist. That is the main. I'm actually a journalist practicing actually with one of the radio stations here in Kano. But at the same time, I'm still an events planner. I had a degree in English, like from University of Maiduguri. That's where I had my first degree. And I had a master's from Bayero University, Kano. And still, I have all certificate courses I took from online courses regarding to events management and planning. And I can still mostly say I am one of the most successful events planner in Kano.
I can testify.
Because
I can testify.
Oh, yeah.
I can.
because I take my time to do most of my jobs, and I don't like disappointing my clients, because basically when it comes to planning, everybody wants you to give your best, and when you're giving your best, it's just something that you can't really explain, expect less from it, right from the planning to the end of the event. My own is, I just feel like seeing the success in every event, and I need to see a smile in every client's face at the end of every event. Like when I met you, I never believed I actually meet you, because it was actually a very time when your friend asked, like, I need you to meet this, my friend, he's very strong like you. So, okay, let me give you the try, let me get to meet you. And when I met you, it was actually cool, because I was actually challenged. It was Ramadan period. You remember, I was still fasting period like this, so it was really tight. But we still got to pull the best show in Kano, and it went well.
Yeah.
Basically, my life is an event planner, so a radio presenter. Then mostly, I could talk for 12 hours when it comes to event planning. It's like a radio presenter. This is just who I am.
Yeah. And I would not give you 30 minutes. I would give you 20 minutes on this my show.
Why?
If I give you this, because trust me, you're going to steal my show.
No, I'm going to steal the show. No. What is the point of what? I wouldn't steal your show. Like, there's another kind of people already joining me. There's one special lady. She's actually an editor of a magazine. She's just joining twice that show. And
oh,
I guess
wow.
She'll be the next person you're going to meet, kind of, because she's a very good person. She's very...
I want to meet her.
Yeah, we will host that. She's already online watching you. So I guess she's going to be one of the next person you're going to host online. And I believe you'll not really regret meeting her.
She's gonna blow my mind.
And I tell you, well, that's just not gonna be the least problem I can say. So
yeah. So now let's get to the current situation in the country right now.
Okay.
All right. The COVID-19 pandemic is really something that we are happy about, but it's here and we have to deal with it. So I'd like to show a little light. What's really happening in Kano has been we know that it has affected events in Kano and all. So what's really happening in Kano right now? What's happening?
Okay, fine. Like Isai Pesh, she's a businesswoman. She will also testify. Our life is always a busy life, from one client to another, to put a smile to a client. Even if you're going to stress, we still need to work hard to put a smile. This has always been our life. But the situation of coronavirus, you find out that everything stands still. When I mean everything stands still, I could tell you the only event I got to host, there was two weddings I had to go to Maiduguri. That's early this year, which is February and first week of March. That is so it got talked that to the end that we don't even have anything to talk about. Now the sleep savings you have already on ground, what you have to start using. So like this is like the best part of savings. You've already kept a few things for yourself. You've saved a bit for yourself. So now it's a time where you just need to manage your life the way the situation is. Kano is locked down. Kano is one of the most busiest place. Weekends, events. I'm in Kano. A lot of places. So for someone to tell you overnight, the life in Kano, the social life in Kano just chops. It's really scary. And at some point, you feel it's the end of the world. But the truth about it is, this is something that everybody is experiencing, everybody is going through, everybody is having issues dealing with. So we just have to play along with whatever comes around. Like, I don't stay at home. I've been working right from the lockdown.
Yeah.
I go to the radio station. I stay for long, working on air. But this is trying to enlighten people and tell people about coronavirus is real. I guess
true.
If you're in a situation where people are yet to still access this, then that's where the problem is. But now that a lot of people are trying to put themselves in your shoes to believe, okay, fine, this is the situation. Most people still have this perception of the government laws at home because they want the people to die. And I try to make people, when I'm making people understand when I'm here, this is not about government. The government don't have in your life. The government don't have a power in your life. This is what is happening in the Western world. You could imagine cities like Dubai, cities that don't sleep like New York, it's actually sleeping by force. So these are things we try as much as possible to make people understand. Accept the fact coronavirus is real. Now, being from trying to control it, we're now in a part where we're trying to deal with community spread in Kano. It has gone from one space to another. And this is things we never prayed for to happen in Kano. Basically, it's really heart-touching that events and social life in Kano got stopped. Nothing is moving. So we just have to play along with the card of whatever we see. And that's why we're just going to revisit.
So now, at least we have let's say 7 more minutes to go.
Yeah, sure.
Yes. Now, the other angle, the news about the deaths. Is it real?
Yeah.
People dying.
People had been dying. Basically, if you've been in Kano, everything is a season. Everything has its own season. The season for raining, there's a dry season, there is a hot season. Now, coming up with the coronavirus and the hot season, a lot of people don't go out of the house. A lot of people are always trying to manage themselves indoor. Most hospitals don't want to accept patients. Most of us don't want to meet a lot of patients.
True.
Don't know who is actually carrying the virus. So these are the reasons why a lot of people, and the weather is not really friendly. You're in Kano, Kano is not friendly. It's never been friendly, but we just choose to manage. Now, according to the state government, they say most people had issues with diabetes, acute malaria, hypertension, to under. But the truth about it is, you're in a situation where nothing is opening. Even going to the hospital scares you that it's actually sick. Like, this is a fear of the unknown. You don't even know what you're going to meet in the hospital. So it scares you before you even get to the hospital. So these are things where a lot of people look at, and it's actually real. The death is actually real. And the only thing we just need to understand is, there's a time for everything. So now is the time for everybody to please understand that we need to be watch things that actually happen. Don't have things who will say we're only Nigerians. Just be great. Survival, not like consoling you and telling you sorry. We want to tell you happy survival. Please off the fan, please. We want the situation where we tell you happy survival, and we're really glad you made it. These are things we want for, and these are things, stories we're able to believe. The death in Kano is real. With the death in Kano, it made me look at my life like, I don't see life as ending. I try as much as possible not to hurt anyone. If other people on the video, these are things I keep preaching in the morning. Please look for a space to forgive me. Or if you have issues with other people, try as much as possible to forgive them. We don't know who is next, and we don't know who is going.
True.
You understand? We don't know who is going, and we don't know who is next. That is why we try as much as possible not to hurt ourselves and not to disobey people around us. To be honest, it's really scary right now in Kano.
Yeah. So sad. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna let you go anyway from my painful. But let's say in 2 more minutes, summary. What advice and all of you have to the people of Kano in general.
Okay, fine. To people of Kano in the north and in Kano. Like, I got a few of my friends already. Hope it's nice seeing you. I got my friends. I got my friends already actually saying, like, the
I have to see you.
Hope, hola, everybody. You guys, I love you guys at the best. 9 minutes before your time. Take your time. The things that I always tell people, coronavirus is a gift. It comes and it will go. I don't want to let coronavirus go with you. I want you to escape so we could celebrate. So we'll have a good Thanksgiving. My birthday is next month. I told myself, if this thing comes and goes, I'm going to celebrate Thanksgiving. I'm not having a birthday. I need people to celebrate it because we made it. I want to advise everyone listening to us or seeing us right now in the north, because I know I had a lot of people seeing us already in the north, that please and please, this thing called coronavirus is actually real. It's killing. It takes your life without you knowing. Now, the precautions, wash your hands, use hand sanitizers. If you're going out, use face masks. Like, I'm asthmatic. I use desert rat. I think it's from when it's not fashion. I use desert rat. I hit the arms of rubber on my neck. And it is like, try as much as possible to be safe and protect yourself, because I will really be glad to celebrate someone. I will not be happy to put on a black cloth and go and mourn my friend. Everyone listening to us or seeing us, I want you guys to always remember, we will overcome this. We will celebrate this. Yeah. And I know Bosteri, you're one person that keeps giving good news to a lot of people. Let's make these people believe. We will celebrate it. And we will come back, all for us, to thank God for keeping us alive.
True.
Just the few things I'm going to say. Our social life is going to come back in the north. We'll have more weddings, more events, more people to do a lot of good things. But for now, let's stay safe and let's try as much as possible to understand everything.
Yeah. All right, guys. The network is a little bit